to this issue involving MP Michael Cooper, who was kicked off the Justice Committee for, among other things, quoting from the manifesto of the Christchurch, New Zealand alleged shooter. He wasn't kicked out of caucus. Now we hear today that the Justice Committee is going to expunge the official record. You are a firm advocate of free speech. How do you feel about going back and changing the official record of words that have already been uttered?
I feel like we are in the novel 1984. Something happened yesterday, and today, because of political correctness in this country, we are erasing that. Nice. They are rewriting history doing that. So Michael didn't do anything wrong. He was expressing his point of view, and that's, we need people like that in a parliament.
Can I just say, we're all members of parliament.
It's too bad that the Conservatives are not here today, and they're not defending free speech. They're not defending the fundamental right in our Constitution, freedom of speech.
Indeed. Would you want him, if they get kicked out of the Conservative caucus, would you welcome into...
It would be welcome our party, because we will campaign on freedom, yes, and free speech for sure.
Are we not into kind of Winston Smith territory here? We're going back and changing and changing the news retroactively?
No. Two things very important. We've all been members of committee. We prepare for these committee meetings. And, you know, here's a member of a committee who looked up a manifesto of a mass murderer.
That's right.
In preparation for a committee hearing where a representative of the Muslim community was going to testify.
Well, he could have done it on the fly.
This was premeditated. Maybe. And I actually have to wonder, and my colleague Randy Boissonneau has, I think, eloquently put the case, that this member should not be part of the caucus of the official opposition of Canada. So that's very important. But on the point of no Conservative on this panel, I just want to point out, Glenn, that every week with you and Don and others, you know, Nathan shows up, I show up. Sometimes issues help our party, sometimes they don't. But we show up and we explain it. And that there's no Conservative tonight on this panel is nothing short of shameful.
But Nathan, let me ask you this. Why not let the comments stand in the record so that people can go back now, in future, and go back and judge them for what they were said? This is the historical record of the highest level of debates in our country. Why should they not be preserved?
It's a shame what they did.
Allow me. We rarely get to witness true evil. What we saw in Christchurch was that. Part of the evil act is not just the despicable killing of innocents targeted for their faith. Assembling in faith.
I don't question
Hold on, Max.
I question the freedom
of
speech.
Hold on. I didn't interrupt you. Now, one of the ambitions of these people who do these acts is to have their words immortalized, their sick view of the world put into places like parliamentary record. For Mr. Cooper to have done this and to perhaps have planned it is to suggest that we will continue and further the conversation.
But we still have copies of Mein Kampf in libraries. People can go back and look at these things.
So we have freedom of speech in this country. Right. We also have limitations on speech that you can't do, which is to incite hatred towards
it.
Let me finish my sentence. We also have limitations on speech which say you can't use speech to incite hatred and violence against particular groups. We also say that there is speech with consequence. What Mr. Cooper did had consequence. We are not free of consequence in Parliament as elected people, and I think it was appropriate to expunge the record from this.
One sentence, Mr. Bernier.
Freedom of speech are the most important fundamental rights, and what Michael said, maybe you don't like what he was saying, but that's part of freedom. If you want to debate, you need to be able to listen to another part. Okay. And he was saying what he believed in, and I think he didn't do anything wrong.
Interesting topic. Thank you all for participating and for agreeing to come in, as the Conservatives did not do.